Hello, we start the first part of the practical session for the master course AI4Omics Data Integration. This first task aims to introduce you to a basic classification pipeline in machine learning with Python and scikit-learn. Our goal will be to train a machine learning classification model to recognize colon cancer from RNA-seq data. I open a Jupyter notebook of the first task. To load and to manipulate data, we will use the package pandas. Let's import this package in our code with the command import pandas. To execute the code in a cell, you can click on the arrow button in the menu bar or to use a shortcut Ctrl Enter. In the next line of code, we load the data from the file colon-cancer.csv using the pandas command read csv. We store the imported values in the variable data. We can display the dimensions of the created data frame with the command shape. Data have 804 rows and 61 columns. With the command head, we can display the first five lines of the data frame. Our data contain expression levels of 60 genes, ADH1C, DHRS11, and so on, for different samples of colon tissue. The last column, tissue status, indicates if the sample corresponds to a normal colon tissue or to a colon cancer. The values will be normal or tumoral in this column. We can also check the types of data in the attribute dtypes. The expression levels of the genes are all float data type. The tissue status is actually a string of characters, which is considered as an object type in pandas. The method describe allows us to quickly access basic descriptive statistics of the numerical data in the data frame. For example, the mean values of gene levels, standard deviations, mean, max, median, and quartiles. Let's proceed now to the second part of this task, which proposes us to display distributions of expression levels. To create graphical plots, we will use the graphical packages of Python, matplotlib, and seaborn. We need to import these packages in our code. I propose you to select one gene, for example the gene DAO, and to plot the distribution of expression levels of this gene across all samples. In the code, in the first line, I define the selected gene, which is DAO. A distribution plot can be generated with the method displot of the seaborn package. The first option is a data frame. The X option defines the column which should be displayed, here DAO, and the hue option indicates that we will display separately the distribution of different tissue status, one distribution for normal samples and another one for tumor samples. The option kind defines the type of plot. Here we use a kernel density estimator. Otherwise, it could be, for example, a histogram. You can try different options and genes. The distribution is displayed on screen. We can remark that the gene DAO is highly expressed in normal samples, while its expression in tumor samples is much lower. We can guess that if we introduce a certain threshold for expression, for example 7.5, we will be able to predict for any new sample if the sample is normal or a tumor. For this, we just need to measure the level of DAO expression in the new sample. If it is below 7.5, then the sample is a tumor, otherwise it is normal. Step 3. Create features and targets for machine learning. In Python and scikit-learn in the machine learning pipeline, we usually prepare the data in a certain format. We need to create two objects. The first object is a data frame, typically named X, which contains the measurements for all available variables or features. In our case, the features are the 60 genes. And the data frame X contains the expression levels of these features. The second object is a list of targets that we want to predict using machine learning. It is usually named Y. In our example, the targets to predict correspond to the column tissue status, containing the types of each sample, normal tissue or cancer. Let's consider a simple case when we have only one gene, DAO, in the data. In this case, we have only one feature, the gene DAO. The data frame X will therefore contain the expression levels of this gene in different samples. And we can display the first three rows of the data frame X. The targets Y correspond to the column tissue status, containing the types of each sample, normal or tumor. We prepare the data. In the next step, we will create a training and a test dataset. In a machine learning approach, we usually split the initial dataset X into two datasets. One dataset, named XTrain, will be used to train the model, and another one, named XTest, will be used to test the efficiency of the model. The samples for these two datasets are selected randomly. The framework scikit-learn contains a special tool to create the training and test datasets. Let's import this tool, name it train-test-split. I propose you to split the data into three folds and to use two folds for the training dataset and one fold for the test dataset. In the options of train-test-split, we indicate the original data frame X, the targets Y, the size of the test dataset, 1/3, meaning that the other 2/3 should be used to create the training dataset. The random state option initializes a random generator with a given number. You can put here any number. I choose 42. If you use the same number, you will obtain exactly the same distribution of samples in the training and in the test dataset, as in this example. Otherwise, the distribution will be different. The option Stratify indicates that the training and test datasets should keep the same proportions of normal and tumor samples as in the original dataset X. In our data, we have 50% of normal samples and 50% of tumor samples. This proportion will be conserved in the training and test datasets. As a result, we obtain the dataset XTrain and XTest, as well as the corresponding targets YTrain and YTest. In total, 536 samples in XTrain and 268 samples in XTest. If we display the first rows of the dataset XTrain, we can remark that the samples have been randomly shuffled. The sample number are not anymore sorted in ascending order, as in the original dataset X. This is also true in XTest dataset. We are now ready to create and to train a classification model. Scikit-learn contains a large choice of different classification models. For our first pipeline, let's select a simple classification model, a decision tree. The decision tree helps us to define an optimal threshold to separate normal and tumor samples based on their expression levels. In the first line of code, we import a decision tree classifier. Then we create an instance of the classifier with some options. The max depth option indicates the maximum depth of the tree. We will use a depth of 1. The criterion option gives the loss function that we want to use. We will use an entropy criterion. It's also possible to use a Gini index, which corresponds to a log likelihood loss function. With the method fit, we train the classifier using the data of the training dataset only, XTrain, and the corresponding targets, YTrain. The classifier is now trained. It could be interesting to display the optimal threshold found by the algorithm during the learning process. We can do it with the export text function. Let's import this function and also the function plot tree to create later a graphical representation of the decision tree. The export text function represents our decision tree in a text format. We can easily understand how the classifier works. For any sample, the classifier considers the expression level of the gene DAO. If the expression level is lower or equal to 7.54, then the decision tree classifies the sample as a tumor. Otherwise, the sample is considered as normal. During the learning process, the decision tree found the optimal threshold between tumor and normal samples, which is equal to 7.54. We can also visualize the obtained decision tree with the function plot tree. Globally, we see the same information. At the beginning, the class for all the samples is initialized as normal. The entropy is set to its maximum value 1. The total sample size of the dataset X-train is 536. After the initialization, the decision tree evaluates the expression level of the gene DAO for each sample. If it's lower or equal to the optimal threshold, 7.54, then the sample class is set to tumoral. We can see that with this rule, the classifier decided that 265 samples were tumors. Actually, only 254 samples are really tumors. 11 samples are in fact normal. The decision tree is therefore wrong for these 11 samples. The classification is not perfect, but it corresponds to the best result that the decision tree could find. We can see that the entropy decreased to 0.25 in this case. If the classification was perfect, the obtained entropy would be 0. If the expression level of the gene DAO is greater than the threshold, then the decision tree considers that the sample is normal. With this rule, 257 samples were correctly classified. 14 samples were classified as normal, however, they are actually tumors. It is an error of classification. The entropy decreased to 0.29. At this step, we trained the classifier using the training dataset only. It found an optimal threshold in the data and can now provide us with a classification for new samples. Let's use a test dataset to evaluate how it performs. The test dataset represents the new patients for which we would like to obtain a diagnosis, if the patient has a colon cancer or not. The performance of the model is usually estimated by a metric. In our example, we will use the accuracy metric. The accuracy indicates how many samples are correctly predicted by the model in comparison with the total number of samples. In other words, the accuracy is the percentage of correct predictions. To evaluate the classifier, we use the method predict. The performance of the classifier should always be evaluated on the test dataset. Sometimes we can also calculate it on the trained dataset just for information to estimate a possible overfitting. In our example, we will calculate the predicted targets for both X-train and X-test. The accuracy calculation is available in metrics module of scikit-learn in the method accuracy score. We need to provide the real targets and also the labels predicted by the classifier. The accuracy is calculated. For the trained dataset, we obtained the accuracy of 0.95. For the test dataset, the accuracy is a little bit lower, 0.93. Our classifier performs a little bit better in the training dataset than in the test dataset. It means that we have a slight overfitting, but the difference is not huge. We can accept these values. Please remember that the only eligible metric to evaluate the performance of the model is the metric calculated on the test dataset. For example, if we need to compare two models, we compare their performances on the same test dataset, which has never been used in the learning process. Therefore, the accuracy of our decision tree is 93%. In the last point, I propose you to create a function that performs all the steps in one pipeline. In the following exercises, we will often perform the training, prediction, and metric calculation steps for machine learning models. It would be useful to create a special function that performs all these steps automatically. The following code defines this function. The input accepts an initialized classifier not yet trained, the training and test datasets, and the corresponding targets. The method fit trains the classifier, then we predict the labels for both dataset and calculate the metrics. In the output, we obtain the accuracy metrics and the pointer to the trained classifier. Here is an example of use. We execute all the steps in one line and we obtain, of course, the same result. Congratulations, we successfully completed the first task. Now you know how to create a basic pipeline in machine learning. In the second task, I propose you to train a logistic regression classification model using the data of all the 60 genes. Good luck!